I wish it to be clearly understood from the outset that no portion of my argument is based on a new discovery. I have discovered neither the historic condition of the Jews nor the means to improve it. In fact, every man will see for himself that the materials of the structure I am designing are not only in existence, but actually ready to hand. If, therefore, this attempt to solve the Jewish question is to be designated by a single word, let it be called a combination, certainly not a fantasy. I must, in the first place, guard my scheme from being treated as utopian by superficial critics if I had described a utopia on philanthropic lines, and I should also, in all probability, have obtained literary success more easily if I had set forth my plans in the irresponsible guise of a romantic tale. But this utopia is far less attractive than any one of those portrayed by Sir Thomas More and his numerous forerunners and successors, and I believe that the situation of the Jews in many countries is grave enough to make preliminary trifling superfluous. An interesting book, Freiland, by Dr. Theodor Herzke, which appeared a few years ago, may serve to mark the distinction I draw between my conception and a utopian one. His is the ingenious invention of a modern mind thoroughly schooled in the principles of political economy, and is as remote from actuality as the equatorial mountain on which his dream state lies. Freiland is a complicated piece of mechanism with numerous cogged wheels catching into each other, but there is nothing to prove that they can be set in motion. Even supposing Freiland societies were to come into existence, I should look on the whole thing as a joke,